On this first day of the week, the 21st day of the month of Av in the year 5771, corresponding to the 21st day of the month of August, 2011, in the presence of family and friends in Minneapolis, Minnesota, the bride, Amy Chaya Oringer, daughter of Carl and Agnes, and the groom, David Ross Weil, son of Joseph and Marjorie, enter into this covenant of marriage as loving companions in life. So far, so good? All right.
Have I told you that I love you? 'Cause you know that I do. Have I told you that I miss you? I do, I do. Have I told you? Have I told you it's all the same? Have I told you that you tear me up inside? Na, 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 na. Do you miss me in the winter? Do you need me to keep you? It's all up inside you. You better than torn. Have I told you? Have I told you it's all the same? Have I told you that you tear me up inside?
Okay, first of all, I have to start, every time I talk, I must do this, and people who work with me know this. I am standing up. Okay, just, you have to know, I'm already standing up. David, let's get real for one hot second. There was a time in our lives when you weren't, let's just say, as attractive as you are now.
Do you miss me in the summer?
I could tell from a pretty early age that she was an exceptional human being. She had this preternatural way of knowing how to make me feel better when I was down. There are many times I can remember from high school when I was depressed about some guy I had a crush on or some play I didn't get into. And little Amy, you have to imagine her with long blonde braids with little blue satin bows on the end, would run into my room and start dancing and singing and jumping on my bed. And pretty soon I would forget all about the stupid boy or the stupid play. She was a born performer. Her sense of humor was about 10 years ahead of her age. All my high school friends thought she was the coolest.
Thinking about what I would say tonight, I remembered that after Amy and David had been dating maybe about a year, I was visiting LA, and I asked David what was most special to him about Amy, and asked if there was anything that bothered him. David, as we all know, is famous for accomplishing more before 9 a.m. than most of us accomplish in a day. So, I wasn't surprised to learn that the only thing that bothered him was that Amy was not a morning person.
Amy and I are 8 years apart in age, and we've been through a lot together. It doesn't seem like so long ago that I was pushing her around the living room in a laundry basket, or watching her give a dance recital in her tiny pink tutu.
David also shared that what was most special about Amy was that he could be himself with her. He loved that he could just be goofy and have fun, and that she appreciated that part of him. At the same time, Amy told me that David is so funny that he makes her laugh until she cries almost every day.
When you've got a woman like this for a younger sister, it can be mind-bending to imagine the kind of guy who could possibly deserve her.
David has an amazingly adventurous spirit, which is something I truly admire. He decides to do something, as crazy as it might be, and goes for it. It's great that he has found someone who shares the same passion for life.
Then, in the summer of 2008, Amy told me about this incredibly cool guy she met in San Francisco, this friend of her friend Stacy. He asked if he could drive me to the airport, she said, and he told me about his work and how funny and nice and athletic and handsome he was. I remember feeling this kind of chill as we talked. There was an excitement in her voice that reminded me of Amy as a little girl, running into my room to jump on my bed.
This ketubah, this beautiful ketubah, which you now receive from your family, represents not only the document that unites you. As soon as it's signed, we'll all sing in here, and then we can take off, because that's really the wedding. But we'll do some stuff in there, too. Mazel tov, you're married. Mazel tov.
On that trip, my early suspicion that these two smart, funny, compassionate, adventuresome people would spend the rest of their lives together was confirmed. I understood that this was a love that was Besharet, clearly meant to be. We feel so lucky that David found someone as special as he is and shared her with us.
Amy, when I held you in my arms for the first time on September 30th, 1981, I thought of all that would be in store for you as you would grow. You had parents who loved you. You had a brother and sister who loved you. You had grandparents who loved you. And you had a home environment where you were going to grow and grow up a happy child. And then I fast-forwarded it to your graduation from high school and college. And I thought about you then. And I thought about what it was going to be like when you found a career that made you happy. But what I really fast-forwarded to was the day that I would have the chance to look at you and walk with you down the aisle to the chuppah, because that was going to be one of the most amazing and biggest moments of my life, and it was. You're marrying a man who completes you, who appreciates you, and who thinks about you before he thinks about himself. He makes you smile. Linda and I knew it from the first time we saw the two of you together, and we know it every time that he looks at you. And we see how his actions in life serve to cherish the diamond that you are.
As you stand under this chuppah, this being a symbol of your Jewish life and the Jewish home that the two of you will build together, we pray tonight that your home be a shelter against life's storms, a haven of peace, a stronghold of faith and love, a place where at the end of each day you enter with the full expectation that your loving mate is there to greet you and to complete you. During these heady wedding days, it's all been about Amy and David. David and Amy, you know, they're getting married. Amy and David, David and Amy, they're a unit. They're going to be a lovely couple. I've heard already 20 times today. Like you were some sort of strange hybrid creature that's going to emerge from the chuppah as one being. You can let that myth go on for a little while. Now, the two of you have a lot of good things going for you. That's why I can stand up here and be so bold as to give you instructions live in concert here. Amy, you told me in the confines of the office and with David listening how wonderful it is that you can feel good about yourself. You can feel that you can be yourself authentically. You don't have to impress beyond what you do and who you are. You can be silly around David. That's important also, very important in a marriage. You love that David has traveled, his sense of adventure that became your sense of adventure too, and that rubbed off on you. The fact that you are a problem solver by nature and that David really believes one can make problems go away in the world, that you can make change in this world, that really joins the two of you together. You admire that he maintains close contact with a lifetime of buddies. That was very moving to you. You like that about him, how he is intellectually stimulating, and you labeled him the most caring man you have ever met. I wanted to marry him when by the time it was like lucky got out of the office. That's really good stuff. And David, you also said some beautiful things about your bride. You love that Amy has a wide range of interests, that upon meeting and getting to know her, you found that you didn't really have a lot of, you both said this, you didn't find that you had a lot of basic disagreements about the way life should be, about marriage, about children, about working in the world, about morals. You said you can be yourself with Amy. So that's pretty good. You guys can both be yourself with each other. That you don't need a filter with her. She's curious about the world. She's up for new things. So when you said like, hey, let's go to London, she said, okay. Her bright outlook on life makes you happy. And that's a good thing. You both spoke of the amazing respect you have for one another and an understanding of the different ways in which the two of you communicate, because it's not identical. You're not the Bobbsey twins here. You're not the two of the same person by any means. But you respect the differences, and your discussions, as you told me, are solution-oriented, I believe were your words. That's good. The two of you are a powerful force, in conclusion. You have many dreams and you have many beautiful ideas and ideals in common. So I can say to you, re'e, as though you were one, ani noten lifnechem, in the plural, I give to you a marriage. Do you, David, take Amy to be your wife, to love her and honor her and cherish her all the days that you shall live?
I do.
And Amy, do you take David to be your husband, to love him, honor him, and cherish him all the days that you shall live?
I do.
Good. These are the correct answers.
Re'at. Re'at.
Mikudeshet li.
Mikudeshet li.
B'taba'at zo.
B'taba'at zo.
Kedat Moshe.
Kedat Moshe.
V'Yisrael.
V'Yisrael.
Be consecrated to me.
Be consecrated to me.
With this ring.
With this ring.
As my wife.
As my wife.
In keeping with the heritage.
In keeping with the heritage.
Of Moses and Israel.
Of Moses and Israel.
Hare ata.
Hare ata.
Mikudash li.
Mikudash li.
B'taba'at zo.
B'taba'at zo.
Kedat Moshe.
Kedat Moshe.
V'Yisrael.
V'Yisrael.
Be consecrated to me.
Be consecrated to me.
With this ring.
With this ring.
As my husband.
As my husband.
In keeping with the heritage.
In keeping with the heritage.
Of Moses and Israel.
Of Moses and Israel.
It's a world out there in need of repair, in need of two people who dream and vision for better things for our society, our country, our world. And so we break the glass. It's kind of the Jewish thing to do, even as the downbeat for the celebration that is to come. We remember a broken world. We save the shards in the hopes that the two of you going out there will give a true inspiration of love to everyone else who needs it so badly. Just come right about here. That's where it is. No, it's hard. Hey, mazel tov.
I was a quick wet boy, diving too deep for coins all streetlight eyes wide on my plastic toys. Then when the cops closed the fair, I cut my long baby hair and stole me a dog-eared map and called for you everywhere. Have I found
there are a few people more important to me than you. Growing up, I delighted in creating a world with you uniquely for us, on our own terms, devised of our own craziest imagination. Our world was a good one, primarily because you made it that way.
Amy and David have been together about as long as Dan and I have. I've never really known Amy without a David. Most of you have probably known Amy or David longer than me, but my world with them is with the two of them together, and it is a very happy place to be. Lottie will never know a world without Uncle David or Auntie Amy, and that's wonderful.
Together you've created a new world on your own terms. Perhaps we'll call it a zoo. That Megan, Lottie, and I are delighted to have season passes too. We love you.
What a phenomenal day it's been today. I'm so happy to be here celebrating with our friends and family. David, you make one handsome groom. And Amy, beautiful. Amy, welcome to the family. I used to wonder what it would be like to have a sister, mostly because I wanted to double my wardrobe. This would be a lot easier if you were 5 inches shorter and lived a little closer. Like in Chicago, I'm just saying.
When we went to visit Amy and David in LA, we saw them living these beautifully woven lives. Amy was sensitive to David's need for activity, David to Amy's need for relaxation. David loved Amy's dancing and Amy loved David's running. They played games together, took care of each other's health, took each other out to fabulous dinners, had this beautiful group of friends.
17 or so years ago, at David's bar mitzvah, I started by saying, if I remember correctly, that I'd been writing that speech since the day he was born. I've been writing this one since about then. You've grown into an incredible young man. And I think that those of us, as we've watched you over the years, we're not surprised. The pressure of expectations sometimes can be kind of tough to bear, but you've handled them with grace and good humor. And you've done well. And you picked well. And for that, I say, Kinnora. Good for you. Good for Amy.
Sweet pea, apple of my eye. Don't know where, and I don't know why. You're the only reason I keep on coming home. Sweet pea, what's all up?
When David called Ryan and me to enlist our help in searching for an engagement ring for Amy, there was such jubilation in our household, I cannot even begin to describe it. The thought that these two would get to marry each other was a dream come true. I couldn't believe we were actually going to have David for a brother. And now that this day is here, it seems like a waking dream. The thought of these two embarking on a life together fills me with the most profound joy. And Amy, I know our mother would have felt exactly the same.
Stay humble, but I never think before I say.
So excited to have a new son in our family and look forward to the time when we'll be able to hold your children in our arms and start to dream of all the good things that will be ahead in our lives, just like I did for you.
It can be a really good, incredible, full life when the person you are with is your best friend. And I think Robbie joins me in wishing you nothing but the absolute best and most happiness that you could possibly have.
We both toast you and wish you many years of friendship, love, and happiness. And by the way, come home soon. London is nice, but not as good as the good old USA. L'chaim.
Sweet pea, keep of my soul. I know sometimes I'm out of control. You're the only reason I keep on coming. You're the only reason I keep on coming, yeah. You're the only reason I keep on coming.